In this video, I am going to show you how to work with sclerotium. Sclerotium is one of the most effective and most expensive natural gums in cosmetic world. It is prepared by fermentation and it's absolutely suitable for application in vegan formulations. You can use it as a stabilizer to prepare conventional creams and lotions. It is excellent in stabilizing low viscosity sprayable emulsions like this one. It is used to prepare hydrogel serums like this under eye caffeine serum that we have prepared earlier. Or specifically because of the yield stress, it is very effective in preparing scrubs and stabilizing when you have suspended particles such as exfoliants. But one of its most amazing features is that although it is not an emulsifier or a solubilizer, it helps suspend lipophilic ingredients in a hydrophilic matrix. This means when you are making a kind of gel or a butter-based product and want to incorporate some lipophilic active ingredients, you can use sclerotium instead of using a solubilizer or an emulsifier. And that brings us to making this beautiful hydrogel deodorant, for example, that the base is hydrophilic, but the active ingredients are lipophilic, or even making a cream gel. I have here 10% oil, but the skin feel is much lighter than a conventional emulsion, and it's more like a gel than like a cream, and it is suitable for very hot and humid climates or for people who want hydration but don't like that fatty, oily feel of emulsions and creams. To prepare all of these products, which we are going to share with you in our membership portal during the coming weeks, you need to properly disperse and hydrate sclerotium. And this is what I'm going to show you today. There are two methods, one conventional method, as you know, with most of the gums, and there is one method that specifically is recommended by the supplier, and that is a warm process. I am going to make two parallel dispersions of sclerotium, one the conventional cold process and one the recommended warm process, and you're going to compare the results at the end so that you can see what is the difference between the warm and cold process, and then you can decide how to proceed in your formulations. The details are, as always, mentioned on my blog. Follow me through this tutorial. I am using two parallel methods for dispersing and hydrating sclerotium to show you the difference. In one method, I have my water preheated between 35 to 40 degrees centigrade. Then I add the gum and let it hydrate at this temperature for about 35 minutes. In the other method, that's the conventional method, my water is at room temperature. I'll add the gum but let it hydrate for the same period, about 30-35 minutes. So I'm increasing the speed of my stirrer. The gum disperses rather easily. Add the gum to the vortex as always. It doesn't take long. This is a 1% dispersion that I'm using now. So I have dispersed all of the gum here. I increase the speed just a little bit and let the gum hydrate at this temperature between 35 to 40 degrees for 35 minutes. And here I will do the same thing, only at room temperature. My 35 minutes are over now, and I'm going to turn the mixers off, and now we'll show you the texture and appearance of the gels prepared by two different methods. Both gels are nice and smooth. The one in the cold process is even smoother. You can see this is the gel, flows evenly. The one with hot process has few air bubbles, but is still very nice and smooth. But the difference is in viscosity, and I will show you the viscosity diagram after I have measured the viscosity of both of them. These are the two gels. This one is the warm process, this one is the cold process.
I use either method to disperse and hydrate the gum, but you need to go through these two steps before making any product with the gum, no matter what you are going to make. The warm process provides you with a higher viscosity, but you can go through the cold process if you don't want to heat your ingredients. Prolong the hydration time between 35 minutes and 1 hour, and then you will have a nice and smooth hydrogel to proceed with and to add your active ingredients to it. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. I am going to enjoy my tea. See you soon in another tutorial. Bye bye.